So Jean-Luc, I want you to tell me about your experience in your 25 years of cabinet maker. Yeah. How did this begin?
When I started learning cabinet making, I started in a sort of college called Compagnon du Devoir. It's well known in France because it's a tough top of craftsman.
Is this mostly traditional, the school? The focus in the school is on mastering each of the...
Yes, but there were no creation, no drawing, and then I decided to realize my own experience in art furniture, to explore more technique and to meet different craftsmen. I don't want to stay with the same technique all my life.
And this is why your work progresses. You're always challenging yourself to learn something new, to do something more and more difficult.
For example, this is straw marquetry. Mm-hmm. It's very special and very hard to use it. And usually people use it on a plain surface, but I decided to explore curved surface.
Which it looks beautiful and works so
yeah,
well.
To have different reflection of black color. And I think it's interesting for my work and my métier. But I'm really a cabinet maker when people open my furniture because I love details. Beautiful. There is no, how do you say, poignée? You took the feather.
Uh-huh, and you open it.
And you open it.
And inside is beautiful. What's the wood on the inside?
It's sycamore, white sycamore.
Beautiful. I have noticed that you are one of the very few people that I work with that when things are made in Europe and come to America, the difference in humidity and temperature does not affect your work at all. When I was working a lot in antique furniture and we would buy something from London or Paris and it would come to New York, they go from 45% humidity to, we're 0 to 100 in New York and everything bursts. Yours comes and never moves.
It's
solid. Perfectly made, always. What's the inspiration for this cabinet? I know you live near the beach. Did you just see some feathers one day?
No.
Did a big black bird fly over you?
No. When I was working on an older creation as a butterfly last year, I decided to use a straw in different details. And I just found a feather on the beach and decided to...
So it was a feather on the beach.
Yeah, to explore it. My work is always masculine. My old pieces are for men.
They have a brutal quality about them.
Yeah, and last year you told me that. That's why I decided to draw the butterfly and to draw the feather.
It's also the difference between warm and cold, because some of the older designs, perfect steel, very cold. Yeah. Where this work is all very warm. It's all curves, it's rounded, the straw is very warm to the touch. They're friendlier actually in a way.
Yeah. That I like all my furniture.
I like it all too, but there is a warmth about
it. And
this
I don't
stuff.
Know what we will explore next year.
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps you will be surprised.
Good. I can't wait to see. Good. Thank you.
Thank you.